A man's stomach shall be satisfied from the fruit of his mouth, from the produce of his lips he shall be filled. Death and life are in the power of the tongue. Proverbs October 18, 2021. Good morning, our Father, our Almighty God, who loves us and has given His all that we might live and enjoy eternity with You. You are more than my mind can grasp. I think on this reality all the time, that You would care so deeply, go so far to reach us and save us from ourselves. You are way more than amazing to me. Astounding does not cover the greatness of Your love for mankind and devotion to our good. You have been more than kind and merciful. My Father, my God, bless the reading and sharing of these scriptures this morning, I pray. I know they need to be spoke to me often that I may think before I speak, for my words have power. I come into this time and to talk to You in Jesus' precious name, Father, Amen. Lord, Jesus, I remember You said, let Your yes, be yes and Your no, no, for whatever is more than these is from the evil one. Matthew 5:37, You were talking about swearing, taking oaths about this or that. That in truth our word should be our word, period. No needing to swear by anything. If I say I will do something, I do it. That is personal integrity. Lord, I know that when I have said something to someone I have tried to perform what I said I would do. Our word should be our word without adding oath or swearing by anything. At one time a man's pledge was good enough without a written contract, a handshake was good. That is not seen hardly anymore, people must protect themselves it seems from harm. Lord, I do believe these scriptures that the power of life and death is in our mouths. I feel caution often when I am about to say things, to keep my lips buttoned up. But, Lord, I also know I do not do it enough. I know I have shared, to put it nicely, things I should not have, which is gossip. And I need these verses to remind me that it is evil and harmful. For I know myself that gossip has affected me, my thoughts about people I have never met, and I make my own opinions then from what I heard, even though I know nothing more than what I just heard. It is wrong, I know, and I need to seek Your grace to help me not to do that and to cleanse my mind of any negative thinking caused by that gossip. But more than that, I need to shut my own mouth more and not share things that are not good and upbuilding about people, especially my family. Even if what I say is fact. Lord, I know that today there is also a lot of bullying in schools and young kids are committing suicide over other kids' words and attitudes about them. That is an example of the power of death in our tongues. And Lord, how we need Your help, Your Spirit in this word and in our hearts to stop this evil. We need prayer back in our schools. Lord, have mercy I pray, oh how we need You. Lord, I come and ask Your blessing today on me to help me be Your child better and to watch my mouth more. I am far from where I need to be. Please forgive me my gossiping and any other negative and death-bearing words I have spoken. I ask You to heal please what harm I have done with my careless lips. I need Your forgiveness and Your Spirit to work in my heart and change my lips to life-bearing all the time. I do not want to be a spring that gives forth both sweet and bitter water, but life-giving all the time. James 3:9-11, Lord, teach me to walk in truth and life. I need Your Holy Spirit to fill me and constrain me when needed. Lord Jesus, in and by Your most holy name I come and give this prayer to You. Thank You for this holy word. Amen.